If you spent any time outside this past weekend, you probably realize it's already mosquito season here in the South. We always worry about protecting ourselves, but our pets need protecting too.
From mosquitoes? Apparently so. According to the most recent numbers, this area is one of the worst in the entire country for heartworms, which are spread by mosquitoes. Who knew? Dr. Wendy Wolverton is co-medical director of Germantown Parkway Animal Hospital, and you're here with Ruthie.
Ruthie is here with me today.
Who does not have heartworms.
What are heartworms for those who don't know? We hear about them all the time.
So heartworms are a parasite that we see very commonly in dogs and cats. Okay. Surprisingly, though, they can also be seen in ferrets, wolves, foxes, and sea lions. Transmitted by mosquitoes. Mosquito bites an infected dog, comes and bites your dog. Causes them to develop into 12-inch long worms that live in the heart that can then cause lung disease, heart failure, and even death.
And so there is a vaccination for it,
We typically use a monthly heartworm preventive.
Okay.
It comes in a lot of different forms. Your pet does have to see your veterinarian for a heartworm test prior to starting on heartworm preventive. But it comes in a monthly chewy. It also comes in topical products that you apply once a month. There is even a shot that lasts for 6 months.
For the heartworm test, is this something that you do maybe on a yearly basis or
once a year? Okay. Our heartworm preventives are about 98% effective.
Okay.
So we test once a year just to make sure your pet's not in that 2%. We do see patients come up positive that have been on heartworm preventive, but it's not very common.
Is there a breed that's particularly susceptible?
There's not. We see it in indoor dogs, outdoor dogs, cats that never go outside can get heartworms because, you know, those mosquitoes can come in the house.
Yeah, I didn't even know they targeted animals, but I guess that makes sense.
There is a treatment for heartworm disease, but it's very costly. Mm-hmm. There's risks involved. And if your cat gets heartworm disease, there is not a treatment for them.
Wow. I did not know that. Are there typical symptoms a pet owner can observe, or do you have to go to an expert to say?
No. One of the most common symptoms that we see in dogs is coughing. Because those worms are in the heart, they cause congestive heart failure, so they can start coughing. Sometimes they'll have a big distended abdomen from fluid buildup in the abdominal cavity. Sometimes they'll have exercise intolerance. And in cats, vomiting is a common symptom, and sometimes sudden death.
Wow.
It's a really scary disease.
Cats tend to mask illness. I'm assuming if mosquitoes are bad already, then we're also going to see more fleas and more ticks because we had a warm winter.
We've been seeing them year-round. We just didn't get a good cold winter this year. Fleas and ticks are going to be bad this year.
So what do we do with that?
So fleas and ticks are obviously not only pesky, but they can also cause life-threatening diseases like Lyme disease, Rocky Mountain spotted fever.
A regular tick can cause that?
Not just for your pet, but also for you.
Okay. For you as well.
So obviously we want to try to prevent that, not only, well, mostly on our pets, obviously. Flea and tick control products come in a chewy. You can feed your pet a little treat once a month to prevent fleas and ticks. There is a topical flea and tick control products that you can get over the counter.
Like a drop on the back.
I don't love the over the counter products. I don't find that they're as safe or as effective. So obviously it's best to get a product from your veterinarian.
Whatever happened to the old the flea collars?
There is actually a collar on the market now that will get fleas and ticks for up to 8 months. That's pretty impressive, but that again is by prescription. You have to get that from your veterinarian. Your over the counter products are definitely cheaper, but they're not as safe, especially if you inadvertently put a dog product on your cat. Can even be fatal. So it's always best to consult with your veterinarian, obviously.
All right.
Okay.
Doctor, thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Ruthie is just chill. Man, she is like,
mellow for sure.
You can come back anytime. Be the show dog.
Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you.